Studio Thomas James varies greatly. One thing that you're always going to see is a lot of attention to relating back to the architecture, a lot of work on the architecture in the very early stages of the project to sort of get the bones right. Scale and proportion are kind of the unifying elements that are always present in our project. I'm Philip Vanderford, the principal designer at Studio Thomas James. Our firm is based in Dallas, Texas, and we really do work all over the world. Today, we're at one of our clients' houses. The fun thing about this particular project, it's actually the fourth house that we've done for this particular client. But they needed like really casual places for the family to like have fun and that were indicative of their young children. But then they also needed their grown-up entertaining spaces and then transitional spaces that were for like just a casual evening. So we really had three sort of dynamics that we were working with in this house. The client has a great backdrop. They have a really, really deep and interesting collection of art. The house is really beautiful when we first installed, but it's just kind of this continued evolution that's really, really makes this particular project, I think, special. We were able to change some things about the architecture, detailing both on the interior and the exterior, that made it really specific to their needs. You actually see the entry from the street. So we wanted a piece of art here that really gave a lot of power. And so we ended up finding this Donald Martin-y piece that was in a really bright saturated red. We created this wall-hung console that we executed in marble. And then we had a local rug maker here do a custom rug for us in a complimentary black and white motif. So for the living room, we primarily were going for like an adult entertainment space. Iconic modern pieces mixed in with custom to get the exact scale right. And then we also mixed in art and sculptural pieces as well. A Ralph Lauren piece that's done in unlacquered brass, and it has a deep ink colored navy. Custom walnut cocktail tables that we made just to get the scale perfect for the space. And then we also had the same manufacturer make a custom walnut credenza. We've also kind of mixed in iconic modern pieces, a beautiful print done by a British photographer that's kind of a playful moment in the room. For the dining room in this home, we wanted to bring some pieces over from their previous home. And so we actually had done this burl dining table for a previous residence, the Trove wallpaper. It's a really bold statement in the room. And then also with the contemporary hand-done lighting. And so we really loved how this was an opportunity to mix some like vintage finds with new pieces. For the kitchen of this project, one of the main focal points is this beautiful Ansack's parquet mosaic that we installed, took it all the way to the ceiling, eliminated the sort of expected upper cabinetry, and replaced that with really strong, vibrant art pieces. Really made it a space that doesn't just scream kitchen. And also, you know, it was a wonderful moment because you do spend so much time in the kitchen. We love the idea of giving you, you know, beautiful art as opposed to all cabinetry. And then in order to make this kitchen very functional, we sort of did this large wall of all of our sort of like function and storage and all of that sort of hidden and very secondary. And it allows you to really focus on the beautiful tile and the beautiful art. We actually did these built-in pieces with self-returning swivels. So it's actually keeps the kitchen looking perfect at all times. And they're a really big, generous scale that kind of counterbalances the large scale of the island. And so they're extremely comfortable. So this has become a favorite spot. Classic modern dining table in that and is really played off well by this new installation of this apparatus fixture. So we actually have an important Richard Serra piece. It's not hidden in the gallery where you're not all the time. It's, you know, very front and center. And we also incorporated some beautiful Holly Hunt upholstery, which again may not be that innate knee-jerk reaction for sort of a casual lounge area, but we thought it was really, really beautiful, and we love the idea that this gets used every day. Welcome to the bar. The clients do a ton of entertaining, so we wanted a really strong, durable countertop material, and then we also wanted something elevated for the bar that had a lot of interest, but that also performed really well. So we went with this Art Deco inspired glazed porcelain by Ann Sachs. And because it being a glazed porcelain, it's extremely durable, but still has this really rich black and gold appeal. And it was such a beautiful backdrop for the contemporary graffiti art. For the office, in this instance, both clients work from home quite a bit. So we needed a space that was beautiful, but that was also quite functional. So we did custom built-ins that we created that complement the desk, that are packed full of sort of that everyday storage. And we actually had found an antique desk that was not quite the right scale and proportion for the space. So we actually custom made this particular desk based on that style, and came up with something really, you know, beautiful, dramatic, and still made it functional for their needs. This color is Nightfall by Benjamin Moore. And the high gloss lacquer allows you to take a space that, or take a color that's quite dark, but because of the gloss, it actually still has a lot of light and a lot of life. And, you know, we were totally into the mix in this space. We have this, you know, hand knotted rug. We have a couple of vintage contemporary pieces. This is actually one of our most favorite spaces in the house. The homeowner really loves this space because with the opening of the doors, it just gives a great extension of the living space. And we furnished it with some beautiful Janus at Sea and Baker outdoor furnishings. We've incorporated these spun stools, little whimsical moment. We have this Twitter blue gorilla that's sort of a fun contemporary moment. So for the main powder bath, we started with this beautiful Ann Sachs mosaic. And with the scale of the space, we loved using something that was a little bit smaller and had a ton of visual impact. And we used that as a basis to create this custom wallpaper where we played with the scale of the fish and the color, and we sort of married those things together. Quite often playrooms are the last rooms that are thought of when it comes to design. The family really wanted a space that everybody could come together, and they wanted something that really felt well designed but that also functioned. So we have tons of storage. We created this sectional out of indoor-outdoor fabric. So it's beautiful, but it also works really hard for them. For this media room, we worked with Ulliston Systems of Dallas and created this kind of magical space. So they incorporated so much great technology into this media room, and it has this beautiful ceiling that gives the illusion of stars. So one thing that we wanted for this room is to it really feel like an extension aesthetically of the rest of the house. David Hicks pattern carpet that was from Stark, and really felt like that it set off the other kind of dark black accents. Using like a really bold carpet and something that's really strong and iconic is a great way to start, to layer a lot of like solids and sort of functional pieces on top of it. So we're really always cognizant of making bold choices. So for the primary bedroom, one of our jumping off points here was this beautiful smoke wallpaper from Trove. And so that was sort of the first inspiration that we pulled from. And then we did these really, really interesting bedside tables and had those done custom. based on the scale of the space, we just needed something that was really overscaled. Lots of texture and layering going on here. Beautiful metaphors, fabric, like a heavy, rich wool textured carpeting. And then that really is a great backdrop for some of the contemporary art pieces, blue and white porcelain that we actually had brought over from a previous property that we had done together. With the volume of space and these big, beautiful windows looking right out in the pool, it's just sort of a magical moment and just feels really, really wonderful. And the way it's tucked around in the corner of the house, it really kind of creates this like great private oasis. For the primary bathroom in this house, we really wanted something that was a really special moment. So in looking for tile, we resourced this beautiful cube mosaic from Ann Sachs that's built up of a collection of Catia marble. It really is this sort of like beautiful, unexpected moment. And we decided to take the material all the way through into the shower, on the back accent wall of the shower, up on the ceiling of the shower. And I think that's what really kind of makes this sort of this dramatic moment in setting an accent marble into the backsplash, just to kind of play off that mixture of materials and play off the floor. We also had this tub done by Victoria and Albert. And so it also kind of played into our black and white tile and the tension between those two materials. What I like about this particular project is we have contemporary moments, clean moments, we have textural moments. It's not really overly slated in any particular design direction, so it feels natural and very easy with a bit of evolution.